Hello guys, it's DJ Kelden the Antidote. I'm back with another tutorial on Sony Acid. I'm hoping all of you guys are safe. Hope you are keeping safe at this corona times. So as you can read the title, it's how to blend or sync songs in Sony Acid. It's a very common question I've been getting from several DJs on how you are going to sync two songs in the Sony Acid. So guys, it's a very simple thing. You are just apply the same concepts that you might be applying in Virtual DJ or when you're using Serato controllers and CDJs. It's the same concept you're going to apply on this point. First thing you have to know how to set BPMs, how to make cue points. So that be the basics that you need to know. So if you don't know how to set cue points, you need to check a tutorial on that. It is already in my channel on Sony Acid. Also, if you don't know how to set BPMs, you also need to know that. Another thing you should know is how to add audio tracks in Virtual DJ. In Sony Acid. There's a tutorial on that, so you have to know those basics first before you come to this tutorial, because it may be a bit complicated for you to start from this tutorial if you don't know the basics. So first you have to check out the other ones, then you come to this one, so that it will be very easy for you to understand it. So what I mean by blending and synchronizing is you're making the beats to match of the both songs, so that it can have a smooth flow. I hope you're understanding me. So that's what I want to show in this tutorial. So I'm just going to show you some basic songs. They're very easy to use, and the best thing to do to learn a concept, you just start using the specific songs I'm using on this tutorial. You just download them on your side, and it's the same songs. Then later you can use your other songs, which you can use. Because if you try using a different song, it may be a bit complicated. So just try to use the same songs I'm going to use in this tutorial. You replicate on your side. Then after you learn the concept, you can try and use other songs. So I'm just going to go through the basic stuff. I'm going to just go through them very fast. There's the tutorials for that which you can check out on the channel. So just create some audio tracks. Just use Control Q like that. Control Q. Let me just make of them. I want to equalize the volume. Control A. Some things I'm going to do them very fast. But if you want to learn them, there are tutorials on the channel. Like for example, how to equalize the sound. There's a tutorial on that. How to set up Sony Acid for DJing. A tutorial on that. So the process, the part I'm going to go slow. Is a part of blending and synchronizing the songs. So after I've added the audio tracks, the next thing I want to do is to add the songs. So I'm going to use the two songs, very common songs in my country, Kenya 254. First of all, big up all 254 DJs. I salute you guys, you're doing a great work. So I want to use a song by Arrowboy. And another one by Bahati. Those are Kenyan artists who are doing a very, very good work in the music industry. So for the first one, I have this one by Bahati and Ethic. Let me just load it like that. If you check it, you haven't set the BPM. So setting the BPM, if you come to this point, you just right click, click properties. Is a real tutorial on that. You can check it in the channel to understand it better. Bitmap. Then let me just open my Virtual DJ. I want to load the song so that I can know the exact BPM. So the BPM is 99. So just come to my Sony Acid. Change its BPM to 99. Like that. So it is already set the BPM. I want to load another song. Yeah. So what you do, just download these songs and you can use them to learn this concept. So if you use these songs, it will be very easy for you to understand. Yeah. If you see, you can see these errors. So meaning the song, it's not in the MP3 form. Yes, try using the other one. This one. Now if you see, I've already, if I load the MP3 file, it doesn't bring the errors, but if I try loading the MP4 format, it brings the error. It's a very common error you get in Sony Acid. So what you do, if you get such errors, just convert the MP4 file into MP3 and it just loads in Sony Acid. So that's an extra thing you have learned. Let me go through it again. If you are loading a song which is in MP4 format, for example, if I tried loading this one and the MP, you can see at the end is MP4, it brings an error. But if I load the same song in MP3 format, there's no error. So if you get such errors, convert it to MP3 and load it in your Sony Acid. So let me go save the tutorial. So I want to set the BPM for the other song. The same process, open a virtual DJ. After you open your virtual DJ, load the song like that. So the BPM is 103. So what you do, you want to set the BPM to 103. The same process, click on the song. 1 minute, click on the song, click properties. It is after it, you set these this loop, one shot, and beat mapped. Set it to beat mapped. Sorry, then you come and adjust the BPM 103. You have to set it the original BPM, otherwise you'll be having troubles when beat mapping. Make sure you have added the correct BPM, the exact one. Even if it is 103 point something, add that one. Then, so you have to, after adding the individual BPMs, want to set the BPM for the whole audio track. Since you can't go down on the BPM because you're going to affect this song, the diggy diggy, you don't want your song to be dragging. It's better it to be fast than dragging. So you just come to this point, change this point to 103. This BPM or this part controls all the audio tracks. All this part from this point to control the audio tracks. So you have, after changing the 103, now the BPM will be 103 from this point as the song follows. The next thing you want to do is set the cue points. For these basic things, as I said before, if you are not understanding them in this tutorial, it's because you have not understood the basic concepts. So just go back to the channel, look for the for the tutorials for BPM setting, setting cue points, setting up a Sony Acid for DJing. Yeah, such basics first, then you come to this one. So the next step is setting the cue point, and the cue point is usually the point you want to start your song, the one with the kick. Maybe for instance you play this one, you can start a point and a cue point at this. Just zoom it, come to this first part, you split it, split using letter S on the keyboard, then you cut, remove that fade. Then you want to drag this song up to the beginning. Then you want to listen through the song to know at which point you are going to blend it. So what else you can do is you can mute this audio track. After muting it, you can play the above one.
Rada safi ane base bambi bambika na juzi jale ni wazimisha bambi bambika adi adi adi.
Just forward on to get the chorus part.
Tukona mola tunajiachilia leo bati yeti kiwafikia.
Let's just forward the song. I want to get the part which has a chorus so that I can blend the this song at that point. As you know, the concepts in DJing, you have to count the bars. There are songs who have 16 bars, others 32 bars. Yeah, so later I'm going to do a tutorial on, to explain on the bars, different parts of a song, the snare, the beat, the drum, and how to count the bars. Eh? So some songs have 16 bars, others 32. There are by bars, I mean the beats. There are songs that the chorus, you find a chorus with 16 beats, others 32, and you have, you know how, you should know how to maneuver through them. So later I'm going to do a tutorial on that, a detailed one, so that you can understand the concepts about music. Eh? So let me just, I want to find the chorus of this song.
Karibu kwa ipati leo, tunauza imani bila mani leo. Ametutoa mbali uyo, uliza kaswa tatu wati leo. Niko chupi. Pewa pewa, sasuli wa peremwa.
Bambi bambika, bambi bambika ka.
Ina kachuki, nika kunki katuti. Kani babi, amedai atacheza. Kani guangi, nilazima chezewe. Pewa pewa, sasuli wa peremwa.
Bambi bambika ka. Bambi bambika ka. Bambi bambika. Adi bambi bambika ka. Bambi bambika.
Can you can mark at this point, you can mark using letter M in your keyboard, mark it. So that is I think that's the chorus.
Nika kunki katuti kani babi amedai atacheza kani guangi ni lazima chezewe pewa pewa saksuli wa peremwa.
Bambi bambi ka ka bambi bambi
bati yeti kiwafikia leo
ati 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 bambi bambi ka ka bambi bambi ka.
So for this song, for this tutorial, for this purpose, you don't need to be perfect in the at which point you are going to blend. This is just an illustration. Later you can listen through the song, you can make your decisions on which part you are going to blend it. But for this tutorial, I'm going to use this point just to illustrate how to blend songs so that they can synchronize. So then the other song, I want to make a cue point, the part I'm going to blend at this part. So you, the same case, you listen through and decide on which part is going to be a cue point.
Magic's anger on the beat.
So for this song, I think you can use this part. The first part is a good kick. This one. So just zoom the same with zooming. After zooming, you can split that part. Cut that one. Now as you can see, our BPM is 103. So you don't have to worry about the BPM. So just follow the steps and you'll be well. Eh? The next thing, I want to drag this part to the point I marked, dragging like this. So already you can see you can see the beats are rhyming. This beat is rhyming that one. This one is rhyming this one. Even if you zoom, you can see. Even if you check the others, they are rhyming. So if you play it, expect it to be blending through. So let's pray, listen through.
Chezewe pewa pewa saksuli wa peremwa.
Bambi bambika.
Ayy. Yeah yeah. Mkwami ya rubo.
Magic's anger on the beat.
Kama mzuke mengupanda kwanzi.
So after you have done that, that is just an illustration. Now you want to mute the, to make, to change the volume of the this song, the upper one, so that the incoming song can be heard clearly. So for that, you need to know how to add the effects. For instance, you're going to add a wah-wah. You know, on the, you're doing a live DJing, is a point when you're blending, you want to add the low so that the incoming song can be heard clearly. So the same concept you're going to apply here. So you just come to this part, you want to add an effects, track effects, click on it. Come to this part, choose the wah fling and wah add, then okay. Then the next part, just ignore this one. Come to this part, look for the like using wah4, click on it, then close this one. Don't know why this keeping and keep popping up. Rename this one for easy work. Wah4. Come to the other one. Now just also to add another effects, the same part, fling and wow add. Okay. If you are finding it hard to understand the steps of adding the effects, there's a tutorial on that specifically showing how to add effects in Sony Acid. Check it out. Then comes to low flang. Then you close that one. Then rename it. Slow fling. Slow fling. Yeah. So after that, what you want to do? You want to come to your audio track. Come to this part there for the first part. You can split that one. Maybe you can choose a. Let's listen through and hear at which point the second song, this one, starts, so that we can know how to arrange our effects. So at this point is the part where the Arrow Boy song, the Diggy Diggy song, is starting. After the intro, so you just come and split the first song, cut it from there, delete that part. So what we want to do, the remaining part, this one, you want to divide it by two. For instance, from there, you can split from there. This part, you want to add it from the slow fling part, cut it, drop it there. Then the other part, you cut it. I'm cutting just the basic keyboard concepts. Using the Control X and pasting it using the Control V, like that. Let's listen in how it sounds. As you can hear, there's some change. If you mute this one, you can hear there'll be a change in the sound. You can hear that transition from the fling to the wah for this sound change. Let's unmute it again. So what you do next, you come to this part at the end. If you zoom this part, you can see at the end there's this stuff. This one is a fade offset. Just drag it again, like that, around that point. So when you play, let's listen through it. You can hear a very smooth transition. Something else you should note, you can change the type of fade. So if you right click on this part, the end part, you can see at the end is fade out type. So currently you're using this one. You can choose this type, just your preference. Let's hear how that sounds. So it's your choice, you can choose the one you want to use. So something else to spice it up, to make this transition sound a little bit awesome, you can add a scratch at this point. So if you don't know how to do scratches, that's another lesson. which needs some detailed information in another concept in Sony Acid. So if you don't know how to scratch, don't struggle with this one. First go to the video showing how to make basic scratches in Sony Acid. So let me just do a basic scratch on this one. I won't explain the concepts, because if I start that one, you'll be getting another topic, which I've already covered in another tutorial, which you should check out before you come to this tutorial. So I'm just making a basic scratch. So for scratches, you have to understand the 16 box rule. Yeah. So let me just make a basic scratch here. And listen through it. A basic scratch. Let me pitch this up to 4. Reverse that one. This is just the loop back. This blue line is it's a loop back. I show you later how to use that one. Let's listen and let's add another one here. Another scratch. Whether making scratches is not difficult. If it's the first time, it may look a bit challenging. But if you understand the concepts, it will be very easy. So you have to start from down there, coming up. You cannot start the other way around. You cannot start with this tutorial going to the other there, because it will be very challenging for you. Let's just listen through and make adjustments when necessary. Can just make adjustment. I don't like it. Let's just delete this one, the first one, that one. Can just try and move this one. About scratches, there is no specific perfect scratch. Just make you just try out stuff and see which fits you best. So yes, no perfect scratch. You just adjust and hear which sounds better for you. So you can listen to this one. Lazima chezewe pewa pewa sasuli wa perembwa. Also don't like that one. Can delete that. So just keep trying out different things and until you get the one that makes you feel sound good. Lazima chezewe pewa pewa sasuli wa perembwa. Lazima chezewe pewa pewa sasuli wa perembwa. What about we eliminate this one and remain with just these ones? Lazima chezewe pewa pewa sasuli wa perembwa. Ai. So let's just stick that on for this tutorial. You can try out other scratch patterns. This one is just good for illustrations, something you can learn from. So that's how you just do a simple transition. So just try using the same song and see if you can come up with the same results. So hope you guys have understood. So if you somewhere you have not understood how to do that transition, you can just comment below. I'll answer the question. Also, you can contact me through WhatsApp. Also, you can join my Telegram channel. Is a link below. So if you want this software, the correct version of Sony Acid, is a correct version in my Telegram channel. I have a Pro 6 and Pro 7 of Sony Acid. You can download them for free. Can get them through the link in the description, the old Jing software Telegram channel. You can grab them for free. So guys, that's all for this tutorial. Hope you have learned something new. So if you are new to my channel, can you subscribe, like and share so that you can continue supporting each other. If you have anything else to add for this tutorial, some corrections, some additions, just feel free to drop it in the comment. so that you can continue learning from each other. Every day is a learning day, and iron sharpens iron. So guys, until next time, be blessed.
Magic's anger on the beat.
Come on, so can we go find a daddy? Daddy, oh, I wanna hit that spot.